Hello, April here from Pelvic Balance, talking about C-section recovery today. I know in my own personal experience that not a lot has changed when it comes to the guidance that we give women after C-section. And this is something that we need to change. So I want to talk about three things that you should be aware of when you are healing from a C-section. Number one is scar tissue. So you go to your physician, they look at your scar, they're checking to make sure it's closed, there's no signs of infection, all important things to look at. However, at that point, your scar has not completely healed. Even though it's closed on the outside, your scar is still healing on the inside, and that gradually happens over time. So women need to be educated on performing scar massage to make sure that the scar tissue does not become excessive. Because if it does, it adheres down to other structures. It's not common, but in some circumstances, there have been people that have had bowel obstructions related to scar tissue. And that's something that can absolutely be prevented. So we really need to be educating women on how to perform scar massage. And that's something that pelvic physical therapists help with. We can assess the mobility of your scar and determine if there may be an issue with scar tissue, and we can treat that. So that's something that you should be aware of. Again, we need to definitely be spreading the word on that. The other thing is your pelvic floor. So just because you had a C-section does not mean that you are spared from pelvic floor issues. Because during the time that you were pregnant, you had more pressure put on your pelvic floor because you're carrying a baby around. Your pelvic floor is an important part of your core. So if that area is weaker, then you're also going to have decreased core strength. And knowing that you already had a C-section, which affects your abdominal muscles, which is another part of your core, then we're really setting you up for poor core strength. So we need to make sure that your pelvic floor muscles are contracting the way they should. They're relaxing. They're working with other areas of your body to regulate that abdominal pressure. And as a pelvic physical therapist, I definitely look at those things. So you should have a visit with a pelvic physical therapist to assess this as well and make sure that you're getting off on the right track in your healing process. Because that can definitely help prevent issues that can develop later down the road. Then the last thing that I would say you need to be aware of is diastasis recti. You may have heard of it. People refer to it as a separation of the abdominal muscles. And when you have a C-section, you can be more prone to develop this, although a lot of women that haven't had C-sections also can develop this. And I don't think we're doing a good enough job at screening for this postpartum. Some women don't even know they have it, so they might not start developing issues until later on, and then we find out, oh, well, it's related to this, and we could have prevented that. Things like back pain, that can be a result of having this because the diastasis recti is abdominal weakness. You have an area in the middle of your abdomen that is very weak. And so you have lost a lot of core strength when that is weaker. Pelvic physical therapists can help assess whether you have it and help treat it. Because it's not just a matter of strengthening your abdominal muscles. There are many factors that go into why somebody develops this and how to treat it. So it's multifactorial and should really be assessed by a physical therapist before you start an exercise program to make sure that you're doing things that are appropriate for you. So those are the three things that I think you should be aware of. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me, April@pelvicbalance.com. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.